We look forward to 3 days of a great opportunity.
The
Lord has given us these days. In order that we can lift him up and praise his name. The Lord has given me the opportunity of sharing with the current people for the past 25 years. The Lord has given me the verse Jeremiah
29:11.
The question I've been asking all the current people that have come to the United States. This is the word of Jeremiah, the children of Israel, as they were being herded as prisoners. In 586 before Christ, 586 BC before Christ, Jerusalem fell under the occupation of Babylon. And I praise God because it was given not only to the children of Israel but to the current people.
Jeremiah 29:11
says, I know the plans I have for you, plans to prosper you and not to harm you, plans to give you hope and the future. So the question I'm going to ask to the current people is, why did you come to the United States? You are now in Louisville, Kentucky. Why did you come to Louisville,
Kentucky?
What's the reason for you to come? Before you came to the United States, you were in the refugee camp. I think everybody of you were in the refugee camps. The refugee camps are reserved for all those that will go to the United States. Others were approved and you were approved, others were not approved, they remained in the refugee camps. So in the midst of devastation, in the midst of defeat under the superior army, the children of Israel were under slavery. You were under slavery. Your ancestors were in Burma, in Myanmar. And you were in the midst of a civil war. The civil war has been going on for 72 years now. And for 3 generations already, it's been going on. And it's not showing that it's gonna stop. In the midst of this, you were allowed to go into the border of Myanmar and Thailand. And all of you were accepted as refugee camps. And you live in the refugee camps and prepared for another area of life. This message that I have been preached all over for the past 25 years. I came to Tita in 1996.
I met Sok Wee Tu, the governor of Tita Revolution. Under Tita was Kothune.
So
I came to Myanmar by way of Bangkok to Kanchanaburi to the border and down into Tita and preach in the first church I preached outside the Philippines. In 1996, no Karen was going to the United States and to other nations. But today, a lot of people, not only Burmese, not only Nepali, not only Africans, a lot of refugees have come to the United States.
In 1996,
I preached at Tiki, Church on the Mountainside.
I
preached this message. That time I didn't know yet about the revolution. I just came together with the 100 pastors to Thailand in order to minister with a lot of people. But the call from the Lord came to me to be a missionary for the current people. My understanding was I'll be a missionary to the current people of Tita.
Well,
I had no idea that the Lord wants me to be a missionary for the current people all over the world. So today I've gone to Canada, to Australia, and to Thailand and Myanmar and preached the current people. So the background of this message, Jeremiah 29:11, I'll tell you a simple story. In 1996, after I preached in the church in Tiki, four pastors invited me to pray for a piece of land. I can't remember exactly the four names, but I can remember two, Carverla and Tradu Korek. I saw the picture of the four of us, five of us, praying for a piece of land. The piece of land will be where the seminary, the current seminary will be constructed, and people will come and study the Bible.
So
it was my understanding that I'll be a missionary to the current people in Tita and be a teacher, a professor of a seminary where the land will be dedicated for. So after praying for the land, we went back to Bangkok and I went back to Philippines. I came back to Bangkok and Kanchanaburi and wanted to go to Tita, but nobody would bring me to Tita
anymore.
I asked why nobody will bring me. They said that the war had started, the enemies had come, and the villages have been burned, the church has been burned, the school has been burned, even the hospital has been burned. So I asked, where are the people that I met? And probably they said in Bangkok.
Now,
the people have escaped, and probably the next stop will be Bangkok. I wanted to go back to the Philippines, but the Lord said, wait.
And
while I waited, it was January 1997 to April 1998. And I praise God because in April 1998 I met Sok Kwe Tu again together with his brother Padu Kosong.
And
together with Padu Kosong, we started what we call the Karen International Gospel Church or King Church, the only Karen church in Bangkok during the time. So I met several persons which I have with me now. I met
Tradu
Salola.
Tradu Salola, no,
he was the first interpreter for me.
I
met Tradu Novelse over there.
No, our Tradu Novelse.
Hallelujah. I met your praise leader over there.
No, the you were not
1998, we met together in Bangkok and started what we call the school.
The Tokugia, which you call in Nepatina, the Bamboko, Ulan in Sarawa, Chudreta Kenelo.
And I met several others that became my interpreters as a priest to the current people.
No, that's in the other, Bamumada, Makora, the Pada, with the Clotina, Lodido, when your food in the panic, and you doing Adok
and Tata Kuso. And so I praise God because 23 years after 1998, I met them together. We are here in the United States of America.
Amen. Amen.
Amen.
The current church in Bangkok is still there until now. Because of the invitation of one of the friends I have, his name is Tradu Rocky. He came to the United States September 9, 1999
together with his
family. I cannot forget the date, 5/9/1999.
No?
And starting the time, a lot of people were already going to Canada, to Australia, to New Zealand, and to European countries.
So,
1998, we started studying the Bible with Fradu Salola and the two others over there.
No, Doctor Kuki Akujikone, Sarah Wadalizo Sijo, Dr. Salola, Dr. Fradu Nubele, the Pukolo.
And I was invited by Fradu Raki to come to the United States and continue the teaching that I started in Bangkok.
No, Penny, no, it touched the old and Rado Rocky, Rocky, and Hera, where Doctor Kuki Akujiki, and you look America, who do.
So that's the background of our passage, Jeremiah
29:11.
I know the plans I have for you, plans to prosper you and not to harm you, plans to give you hope and a future. So over the years, you have come to the United States because of four plans of the Lord.
No, you need to say, say, oh, I think that Luigi, come here, and have a call, America.
The plans of the Lord is to, number one, to prosper you.
No, turn in here, I want to put on your own,
What does prosper mean?
Tell the prosper mean, and tell the prosper mean, and tell the prosper mean, and tell the
prosper means to give, to make you rich.
No, tell the prosper mean, and tell the prosper mean, and tell the prosper mean, and
I'm very glad for meeting my friend here. I stay in his house.
I'm a
very good interpreter.
Thank you so much.
And very good in praise and worship.
Praise God for
singing praise songs in the spirit. You must teach how to sing in the spirit. Ephesians 5:19 says three songs that we give praise to God.
No, what episode 5:19.
He says give praise through psalms, hymns, and spiritual songs. Psalms are those written in the Bible that you sing.
Hymns
are those written by other people, not written in the Bible, but writes about our being born again and being a new life in Christ. Amazing grace, and you were saying joy to the world.
Amazing grace, no joy to the Lord.
But the most important is the songs of the Spirit. You sing psalms that are written in the Bible. You sing hymns written by other people. And you sing to God from your spirit. I can only hear one singing the spirit. Everybody should sing in your spirit, lifting the name of the Lord. Hallelujah.
It's
singing praise to God from your own spirit, from your own self.
No.
And those are the things that I'm teaching now. When he was singing the spirit, I was also singing the spirit over there.
No, singing
the spirit with the music, with the accompaniment, with the chords and the pitch, and singing in Filipino, singing in English. Everybody should sing in your spirit.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. If the Lord is living in your heart, if the Holy Spirit is living, the Spirit of Holy Jesus is living in your heart, then you must sing from your own self, from your own words, from your own spirit.
Amen.
Praise God. Cup offering.
Amen. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen.